Hello Internet, this is Oscar Velisa again, this time with a follow-up video to fixed point iteration where I'll be answering some of your more common questions. So I would recommend watching that video first if you haven't already. The first question we'll go over is, why not choose x is equal to x squared minus 1? With our function being x squared minus x minus 1, it seems like the easiest way to isolate x would be to simply move it to the left. But as a rule of thumb, you want to try to reduce the degree of the polynomial that you're trying to find the root for. So x squared minus x minus 1 has degree 2, as does x squared minus 1. So essentially we're saying x sub n plus 1 is equal to x sub n squared. This will work if you use Wegstein's method, but we'll come back to this. As an example, if we use g of x is equal to x squared minus 1, and if you start at the value of 2, then this function causes our iterations to diverge monotonically and quite quickly. If we started at 1, then our function will eventually start bouncing between 0 and negative 1, and even if we start very close to the root, say for example 1.6, this also causes our function to diverge. Here's another common question, which is, how do we come up with 1.618? If we take our function g of x is equal to 1 plus 1 over x and iterate, after about 38 iterations, this becomes the value phi, or 1 plus the square root of 5 over 2, which is approximately the value of 1.618. This will be related to further questions too. Also commonly asked, how do you pick a starting point? The main idea is that you should pick a point that is in the neighborhood of your root. If we plug in 1 inside of our function, we get the value of negative 1. If you plug in 2, we get the value of 1. Therefore, we know our root is somewhere between 1 and 2. You could also try using a root of a similar function, or you can always try graphing the function. Let's try graphing. Here, 1 is a pretty good guess. 2 would also work, but even better would be the guess of 1.5, or even better still, 1.6. But what about the other root? Is there a way to find the other root using the same approach? Let's look back at our two main examples. Our first on the left, 1 plus 1 over x, converged to 1.618, and our function on the right diverged. If we instead start at the point minus 1 and do fixed point iteration, this eventually converges to our second root, 1 minus the square root of 5 over 2. Recall how I mentioned that using x is equal to plus or minus the square root of x plus 1 was a bad idea. Well, it still is a bad idea, but you can break it into two separate functions. For our function on the left, if we start at 1 and perform fixed point iteration, eventually we converge to the value 1 plus the square root of 5 over 2. For our function on the right, if we start at the point negative 0.5, this eventually converges to 1 minus the square root of 5 over 2. You should still be careful when using square roots because this might lead to you needing to use complex analysis. For example, our function on the left, if we started at minus 2, it eventually converges after 14 iterations, but you have to use complex math. Our function on the right will also converge to our second root if you start at the value of 1 only after 60-something iterations using complex analysis. And here's the last question we'll go over. Folks seem to want to know, how do you use the convergence test without the root? Also related, which root do you use in the convergence test? Recall our convergence test requires g prime, and that if g prime at our root is less than 1 in absolute value, it passes the test. And when it's greater than or equal to 1 in absolute value, it fails it. If we instead apply our other root to this test, now our equation on the left fails it, and our equation on the right passes it. If we take our original function and start very close to our second root, this appears to be diverging, which we would expect since it failed the test with this root. If we do a closer inspection and keep iterating, eventually the function converges on our original root. Think of the convergence test as, will this function converge to this root? Passing the test means that it is guaranteed to converge to that root, and failing it means that there is no guarantee, so it can still converge even if it fails. If it's converging too slowly, you might consider applying Stefanson's method to speed it up, or you can use Wegstein's method and avoid the convergence test altogether. Stefanson's method and Wegstein's method are both ways of accelerating convergence of fixed point iteration, and in the case of Wegstein, can actually induce convergence when the function diverges, I have example code for both of these on GitHub. And as always, thank you very much for watching. If you have other questions that you'd like me to answer or other suggestions for future videos, please be sure to leave them in the comments.